Dirty feces. Have you seen that drip tray?
Where the heck do you sleep?
You wouldn't get me on that bed.
Can Kim and Aggie prevent this New York firefighter from going down in a blaze of filth?
Ah! God, that's disgusting!
Great Britain's Countesses of Clean, Kim Woodburn and Aggie McKenzie, have come all the way to New York City to make the Big Apple shine.
Well, here we are in the Bronx, Aggie.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Nice,
I know.
This week's grime suspect, Tom O'Rourke, a 45-year-old retired fireman with an alarming problem.
My house is in bad shape. Last time I slept in my bed was about 2 years ago. I get buried in a pile of clothes and have to send a search team to find me.
Big strapping fireman.
We don't know
They've
that.
Got to be though, haven't they? Muscles.
Would you please put your hands on the wheel and pull yourself together, woman?
I'm divorced. I have a 12-year-old daughter. I see her on weekends.
I love my dad, but his house is a complete mess. Everything is everywhere.
Megan is going to be so happy when this house is cleaned. She'll be able to invite her friends in and do what normal young ladies do.
But he's been retired 2 years, hasn't he?
Got no excuse not to clean his house, really.
Tom likes to go out and have a good time. And maybe that's part of the reason that his house isn't as clean as he would like it.
I'm tired of walking into my door and seeing this huge mess. It's time for me to clean it up.
Our daring disinfectors rush in to sift for clues among the clutter.
Black bin bags at the window. It's a bit scary, isn't it?
Oh, come on, get in.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, look at the filth!
Do you think these are meant to be curtains? Oh! Look at the television. Clean me now.
Now, how does he see to watch this now?
Like, it's like coal dust. Much junk everywhere. Big strong man like him. You think he could clear this lot out in 5 minutes?
I have a lot of junk, and it's just easier to put it on the side and try and get to it later. And eventually later never comes.
Look at this flaming phone. That is just disgusting.
If anything jumps out at me, I'm going to go nuts. I'm telling you now. Honest to heavens.
Tonya. Oh, look what else I found in here. 1999. Abby. Never been opened.
Oh, Wacky, I'm gonna fall. Why does he not just put all this in the bin?
Kim, I think this is your department.
Oh, underpants. They're right under my nose. Oh, stop. Get out. Get out.
The smothering stench and slop have spread into the kitchen as well.
Oh, my God, this is awful. Look, Kim.
I haven't eaten at my kitchen table in about 4 years. I haven't entertained since 1996, and I'd like to have my family over real soon.
Ooh. See, this should be put in the rubbish bin. Look at the color it used to be.
Oh, Kim, look at this underneath. This is all water, stale food, and muck over the years, and it hardens into a bacteria crust.
Hold on to your helmets. Kim's going in. Or up.
Your skirt's so tight I can't get up there. Now, Aggie, I've got to get the other shoe off.
Come on.
Oh, get the other shoe. Get the other shoe.
Oh, okay.
There we are. Get the other shoe.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Fantastic.
You know, it's like a fur coat, isn't it? That is amazing.
Oh. I can't take much more. Come on.
A fire may be the only way to wipe out the slime in Tom's befouled bathroom.
I feel as if I'm standing in a bit of a fungus pit. There's all black mold everywhere.
Oh!
Don't go too near. That could be dangerous, I promise you.
Come on, I've seen enough. Come on.
Oh, dear me.
The one space that hasn't been engulfed by grime is maintained by daughter Megan.
The poor thing's got to climb over all that trash.
Oh, the little soul's trying.
Well, and this, actually, good gracious.
The carpet's very dirty, isn't it?
Compare with that one out there.
No comparison, is there?
Right, come on, Alexa.
Right, yeah. So let's venture on.
Be brave.
Into the valley of death.
Our brave Meyer fighters face a conflagration of contaminated clothing in Tom's bedroom.
What is all this, dear?
I don't know.
Well, he's certainly not entertaining any young ladies in this house, is
he? Well, do you want to take me on this bed? I can quite assure you.
Kim, I'm talking young.
There may be snow on the roof, dear, but there's a fire raging down below, given half a chance.
Mrs.
We've got to have a word, because he's got to get rid, because we can't
do this. A big word. A major word.
The filth has reached a flashpoint, so Kim and Aggie confront the culprit.
Tom, I presume.
Yes.
Get up there.
Get in.
Excuse me,
Kim
go
and Aggie,
away.
Come on.
What a hoot, you
stop
dirty
thing.
Get in.
You don't want your daughter coming in contact with that, do you?
Aggie has a scorching surprise about what's brewing in Tom's kitchen.
It's potentially fatal.
And can Kim ignite Tom's passion for carpet cleaning? Cleaning Commandos Kim and Aggie have come to rescue newly retired firefighter Tom O'Rourke, whose home is smoldering with slop. Tom wants the place perfect so his young daughter will visit more often.
I feel as if I'm standing in the middle of a fungus pit.
Stand back, the sparks are gonna fly.
This is a complete mess. What is going on?
I'm in a quagmire here. I clean little spots here and there, then I forget about that area and concentrate on another one, and it's got a little overwhelming, and it's easier to walk out the door and leave it behind.
That bathroom as well, it's in a terrible state. It's full of black mold everywhere. It looks really dangerous to me.
You're a handsome man. You live like a dirty beast.
And I'm tired of my daughter not coming over.
She must hate it here.
Have you seen that drip tray?
That was washed about 6 months ago.
Lie.
A year ago.
How long ago?
About 3 years ago.
And listen, what about your bedroom?
I don't have a washer and dryer, and if I did, I'd be able to fold them and put them away right away. So I just toss it on the bed.
And where the heck do you sleep? Your bed?
I sleep here on the couch.
Plastic.
How'd you get a woman on that bed, please?
You don't.
You've got loads of potential, you've got loads of space.
It's gotten too far, and I don't know where to start.
He'll start by stamping out the staggering stacks of stuff.
So very little in there and loads in these trash bags.
Get shaping.
It's going to take forever to go through this.
You can still be quick.
Keep going.
You guys got me working hard now.
We have. We're ruthless when it comes to this sort of thing.
This is harder than fighting fires.
Well, don't nobody ask you to stop, dear. Get down there.
All right.
Very nice women, you know. She's in the right building.
Faster.
My knickers.
Oh, don't worry, we've seen them already.
You've seen them, dear. Not a pretty sight.
Yes.
We'll be back.
Yes.
We'll be back. Stuck in.
All right, I'm going to keep cleaning, okay?
While Tom does the decluttering drill, our sanitizing sirens speed to the station and suit up in their grime fighting gear.
Some stuff, Axie.
Oh, I think we've got a good one here, you know.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, I do. He's a big, strong, healthy guy.
Oh, he is.
He's got no reason not to clean.
No.
He's motivated as well, isn't he?
He's after a woman.
Yeah.
And once a woman's on the scene, he'll do anything.
He just needs a few tips on where the girls to give them to him.
All right, come on, Axie.
Come on, let's get moving.
Let's get moving.
Now it's time for Kim to get our hometown hero hot for housekeeping.
You keep a nice figure, don't you?
I do. I try.
Right. Now I'm going to try to keep a nicer figure. When you do housework, manual, and you use a vacuum, did you know that for every hour, you burn off 200 calories? We'll pretend we've got the vacuums in our hand, right?
Okay.
We go left, right, left, hands on hips, thrust. Oh, lovey, thrust. Don't tickle, thrust in. Thrust. We're getting there, dear. Rome wasn't built in the day, dear. The way you're shaping, it'll take a year. Now, together, one, two, hand on hip. Thrust. Getting
okay,
quicker.
Okay, I'm getting better now.
Yes, I'm a good teacher, you know. Come on, dear. One, two, You can't say that's hard work.
It's not hard work at all.
And look at the lovely colour of the rug. Now, stop the vacuum. It's lovely and clean. Let you and I go and thrust together, dear.
All right, let's go thrust.
Be gentle with me, won't you, darling?
Tom's kitchen is in critical condition, so Aggie gives his cookware a little CPR. That's cruddy pan resuscitation.
Because you've left this pan lying dirty for so long, it's now difficult to clean.
Okay.
Get a couple of denture tablets here.
Mm-hmm.
Stick them in the pan, then put some warm water over the top. Right? Now, because you've been such a good sport, while that's bubbling away, we're going to have a glass of bubbly. It takes about 10 minutes for that to work its magic, and I can't think of a better way to while away 10 minutes. Delicious. Now let's see how this is getting on.
Wow, look at that.
No effort required.
No.
See, all you need to do now, actually, even with the force of the water that's coming off, isn't it?
Thanks for the tip.
Good one, that. Here's a clean house, Tom.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheerio.
Tom spent 20 years getting covered in ash and soot. But that doesn't mean his appliances should do the same.
Your place is thick with dust, you know that, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Right. And I've got here, it's called a Swiffer. It's not going to spread the dirt. It's gathering and impregnating into this wonderful Swiffer.
Swiffer?
That's it, it's electromagnetic. It's a very clever thing, you know. When people say housework is hard, no, it isn't. Get this all, look at it, you see? This is excessive dirt and dust.
You're right.
Yes, look at this darn camera. How can you be so dirty when you're on a cleaning program? Dirty devil. This is filthy.
A clean surface should be in the lower hundreds.
Is Tom's kitchen down for the count?
731,000.
Oh my God.
And guess who's racing to the scene for the flashy reveal? Devoted father and firefighter Tom O'Rourke is getting some emergency assistance from our dream cleaning team. Kim's even helped him add a little va-va-voom to his vacuuming. But Tom's place is still highly hazardous. In fact, Aggie's evidence suggests that bacteria is burning down the house.
In your bathroom, there are traces of E. coli. In the sink and in the bathtub, it can easily lead to serious food poisoning. You don't want your daughter coming in contact with that, do you?
No, not at all.
No. Judging what's in your bathroom, I can't imagine what's in your kitchen, Tom. So I'm going to take a swab off your delightful dish drainer, because I think it's probably bogging with bacteria. Let's see what your reading is here, Tom. A clean surface would be in the low hundreds.
Mm-hmm.
Anything beyond that is unacceptable, okay? 731,000.
Oh, my God.
It's completely unacceptable. We've got to get cleaning now. Put your lovely gloves on, specially made for you. I've got some warm soapy water in here. I'm going to add to it a little bit of bleach. Now, the reason I put bleach in here is it helps to kill the bacteria. Scrubbing brush.
Okay.
Ooh, he's very keen to get going. I see you're putting those fireman's muscles into it. I like that. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Carry on with the good work, okay?
After battling the bacteria, Tom snuffs out the splatter.
I didn't think you could clean the stove with this.
Of course you can, dear.
And Kim shows him how just a spray and a spatula can safely strip off stickers.
This is a lubricant. It's used to loosen all sorts of squeaks. Men have it in their garage. I'm giving it quite a good soaking, right?
And be gentle. We're not desiring to take the paintwork off.
And we won't. Gentle. Don't batter it to death, dear. Caress it. Right, get on with it. Thank you, my dear. I'll be back shortly.
To extinguish every last sign of grime, Tom's gonna need backup. So Kim and Aggie call in the Volunteer Brightening Brigade.
Lifesavers! Thank you.
Oh, lots of work to do.
Thank you very much.
Quick. Lots to do.
Come on, Aggie.
While the team filth-proofs the premises, Tom douses the dirt in the kitchen.
You don't even need a mop and a bucket. It does both.
Now he's got to quench the crud on that shameful shower curtain.
What is this?
It's soap and dirt.
Well, don't boast about it, dear. Well, get the thing down.
All right.
Oh, you're a dirty devil, you are. Now, put your stopper in, dear. Run the water.
Okay.
Tide is used in washing machines. It's used for hand washing too. And I soak my undies. Oh, they sparkle, dear. All the lace, dear, sparkles. But that's between you, me and the gatepost, dear. Get your tootsies in that bath.
Okay.
Hummel away, dear. Treading the grapes. Imagine it's a wine-making night. Now, keep going. You'll have lovely, clean feet. I'm going to show you something that's going to shock you. This curtain was disgraceful. Look at this already. It is clean, my love. Let's rinse it in a bit of cold water.
Okay.
Now, you know what that curtain was like, don't you? I mean, you've seen for yourself. You've not been going mad. You've not been in this bar 5 minutes. And this was so filthy. I mean, it's nice. Look at it. Now, you rinse that until there's no soap left in it.
Okay.
Hang it straight up, my love. Do a good job. I'm watching you.
The countdown to cleanliness is heating up. Tom is evacuated from the premises while our tidy troop takes over. Everybody is working up a sweat. Well, almost everybody. Kim and Aggie stop, drop, and roll out the big reveal.
Is this my house?
And Tom's not the only one in for a shock. Kim and Aggie and their squad have done some serious scrubbing in firefighter Tom O'Rourke's combustible cottage. Now Tom hotfoots it on home to see if they've smoked out all the scum.
Are you ready for this?
We have got a wonderful surprise for you. Yes.
10 for a good buddy. Bring on the surprise.
Oh my God, it's my daughter. Hi, baby.
Hi, Megan. Can you imagine what it's like to have a clean house?
No.
No. Well, we're going to show you.
We've got a good surprise.
You ready?
Come on.
Come on,
all
you
right,
two.
Let's go
in.
Tom's living room was foul and flammable. But now it positively glows.
Oh, my God.
Have you never seen it like this?
I don't think so.
You've even got proper curtains in the window. How about that?
That's beautiful.
This is a very nice
home. You guys did a great job. Definitely.
And you're going to keep an eye on him, are you, Megan?
Yep.
And if he steps out of line, tell him off.
Yeah.
Squeezing into or out of Tom's bedroom required the jaws of life. Now it's spacious and spotless.
Can't wait to sleep in my own bed, finally.
Good.
The backdraft of bathroom odors and black stains made this one unrestful restroom. Till Kim and Aggie lit a fire under Tom's backside. Tom's mucky mess was threatening to consume Megan's room as well. But now, it's a safe place for a pristine teen.
It's so clean.
Crazy, she's really enjoying it.
She's really nice.
The kitchen was engulfed in sludge, slop, junk, and germs. Now this room is cooking.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh my God. I don't believe this. Is this my house?
It's sparkling, it's gleaming.
Somewhere to dine. Megan, somewhere to dine with Pop and your friends.
And now Kim and Aggie help our firemen prevent future filth.
What do you think?
New washer and dryer.
This is a whirlpool duet. Every time you wash the bundle, put them away. Don't keep going and tossing them on your bed.
We've left you with these supplies to get you started, okay? So no more excuses.
This is unbelievable. I am overwhelmed.
You meet me, little Tom. Thank you very much.
That's gorgeous.
You're so sweet, little sweetie pie.
I'm going to keep it clean now.
I hope you do, because it's smashing. Don't let it get messed up.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
It's been 2 weeks since Tom's four-alarm dirt disaster. Has he kept it under control? Well, the front room is free of flare-ups.
It feels great to walk in the door having a clean house.
Tom's room is still unscathed by those scads of dirty clothes.
I'm cleaning my bathroom once a week now. It's a lot easier keeping up on it.
And there's no need to duck and cover in the kitchen.
I can actually eat at the kitchen table, and so can Megan.
Now that the house is clean, I love to bring my friends over. I spend a lot more time hanging out there now.
So how clean is my house? It's clean.
Tom's tidy triumph has given Kim and Aggie something to celebrate. So they're off to New York's fabled Broadway Theater District.
Oh, Axie, it's nice to get out and about in Manhattan,
isn't it? Day, isn't it?
Smashing, Axie?
Oh, bugger, I've got pen on my handbag.
Don't worry, dear. I will get the pen off for you. Come on, Axie, in we go. Hello, have you got hairspray?
We're sold out for tonight.
Hairspray, dear, hairspray.
Yeah, we are sold out.
You're advertising hairspray outside?
Yes.
Hairspray.
Oh.
It's a culture difference, Kim.
I give up.
Is somebody looking for some hairspray?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, thank you. Ink on a purse. Right. Then I take this, and then I just simply go like that.
Oh, God. Good as new.
Thank you.
Really much.
This clean first. Right, Tom.
Okay.
I think we'll put you in charge of this. Put your lovely gloves on. Oh. Specially made for you.
Thank you.
God, we've got two left-handers.
Well,
sake. What's going on here?
Is somebody looking for some hairspray?
Oh, we certainly are. Says she, falling over. No, I fell over then. Go on. I fell off the wheel, I went.